No, Cormier fought a great fight, but it looked like in that third period to me that it was almost a little rope-a-dope. I saw John Jones letting his foot off the gas. I saw Daniel Cormier starting to find his spots, and all of a sudden, Jones out of nowhere comes over the top and ends the night.
And it was a beautiful setup. He was going to the body all day, knees to the body, kicks to the body, and you can see Daniel Cormier holding his hands down, looking for the body, and here comes the kick to the head. John Jones is so creative out there, using every weapon, his hands, his elbows, his knees, his legs. He's switching from southpaw to conventional. It was outstanding performance.
Gilbert, it appeared as if early on in the fight anyway, you know, the second time we're seeing these guys go at it, but the advantage in terms of the reach and the height really stood out to me. I think it's about a 6-inch height advantage that Jones had and about a 12, 14-inch reach advantage. Cormier just wasn't able to overcome that, was he?
No, he wasn't, but he was doing a lot better than the last fight. If we look back at the last fight, at this moment in the third round, Cormier was way more tired. He actually had some momentum. He won the second round. He was a little more disciplined, not pushing too forward into the long reach and into the knees, taking his time. But again, Jones set him up with the kick, and not only the long arms, but the long legs. That leg got up high out of nowhere.
Look, Jones was using the hands. He was doing what he does to distract. He was using the hands, making him look. Then he was kicking him in the leg. Then he used the hands up here, and he kneed him in the body. John Jones was doing everything right, but Daniel Cormier was finding his moments. I'm telling you, as a fan, I almost feel robbed from this moment. I'm so curious. What would have happened in the next 8 and 10 minutes had that head kick not landed? Cormier was picking his spots. He wasn't wrestling like he told everyone he was going to do. He was out there boxing with him, but he was getting over. And John Jones, it's John Jones, man. The guy is so good, and it's something we need reminded of often. And I think in the last year we might have forgot a little bit.
Because you know what? And he's done it to himself, though, right? I mean, you know, he's robbed us of the opportunity of seeing him. He's, along with Conor McGregor, the biggest star in the sport. He was convincing tonight, but did he show you enough to let you know he is back at the level that he's been at in the course of his career?
Yeah, he really did. The only criticism, and I got to search to find criticisms when I watched John Jones fight, but one thing I did observe is he really did take his foot off the gas. I mean, he slowed it. He came right out in that first frame, and he started a fist fight. There's no feeling out process with John Jones. The kicks, the punches. But by the time the third round came around, he was standing there a lot more. He wasn't having the same output, and DC was really landing. But it looked as though John was just filling up that tank, filling up that energy tank, and he came right over the top full speed and put him down.
Gilbert, the question that you always want to know after these big fights is who's coming up next. And we've heard one name that's been floated out there a lot that certainly would make for a big money fight, and that's Brock Lesnar. And after the fight, John Jones said, you know what? I want to make that happen. Does the public want to see that fight?
Oh, I want to see that fight. The public, of course. I think that's the hugest fight out there. I think it's more than just MMA fans. I think normal people who don't watch MMA, it's going to bring a whole new demographic to the sport if they put that fight together. And, yes, I'd love to see it. And it's very interesting because, yes, John Jones is very dominating, but Brock Lesnar has about 50 pounds on him, and that makes a difference. And I am curious to see what would happen if that. But there is another guy by the name of Alexander Gustafsson who had a very close fight with John Jones. And if anyone almost beat John Jones, if anyone showed some weakness against him or anyone showed the weakness of John Jones, it was Alexander Gustafsson, and he's very talented. And if not Brock Lesnar, then Alexander.
I text Brock Lesnar, and I asked him about this to give comment on SportsCenter. Do you know what he told me?
What did he say?
Nothing. He ignored me. However, I know Brock well, and I will tell you this. He is an animal, and if you insult him the right way, he has an ego, and he will respond. As ridiculous as this fight sounds right now, I personally think there is a good chance it happens.
Does that happen often? Does Chael get ignored often throughout the UFC
community? I'm not crazy about being ignored by old Lesnar, actually.
Really?
Maybe he's asleep.
Although I have a feeling he might be watching this fight to know that there's a possibility.
Now.
Yeah, indeed he is. Of course, this is going to overshadow the other fights that went down. And we'll get to Tyron Woodley in just a minute here. But Chris Cyborg, talk about John Jones maybe being the baddest man in the UFC. Chris Cyborg let the world know that she's the baddest woman in the UFC tonight.
Absolutely.